Long ago, people did not have any means of transport. They used to move only on foot and carry goods on their back. Later on, they began to use animals for dash. Answer: transportation. The dash through water, roots, boats were used from ancient times. Answer: transport. Dash was simple log of woods in which a hollow cavity could be made. Later, people learned to put together different pieces of wood and give shapes to boats. Their shapes imitated the shapes of the animals living in water. Answer: boats. Invention of dash made a great change in modes of transport. Answer: wheel. Dash were used to pull carts that moved on wheels. Answer: animals. Until the beginning of the dash century, people still depended on animals, boats and ships to transport them from place to place. Answer: 19th. The invention of dash led to the development of new means of transport. Answer: steam engine. Railroads were made for dash, driven carriages and wagons. Later came automobiles such as motor cars, trucks and buses. Answer: steam engines. Dash and dash were used as means of transport on water. Answer: motorized boats, ships. The early years of 1900 saw the development of dash. These were later improved to carry passengers and goods. Answer: aeroplanes. Dash are some of the contributions of the 20th century. Answer: electric trains, monorail, supersonic aeroplanes and spacecraft. Sometimes there are dash whose length or width we need to know. Answer: objects. Dash means the comparison of an unknown quantity with some known quantity. This known fixed quantity is called a unit. Answer: measurement. The result of a dash is expressed in two parts. One part is a number, the other part is the unit of measurement. Answer: measurement. In ancient times, the length of a foot, the width of a finger, and the distance of a step were commonly used as different units of dash. Answer: measurement. The people of dash must have used very good measurements of length because we see evidence in excavations of perfectly geometrical constructions. Answer: Indus Valley Civilization. A dash as the length from the elbow to the fingertips were used in ancient Egypt and was also accepted as a unit of length in other parts of the world. Answer: cubit. People also used the dash as a unit of length in different parts of the world. The length of the foot used varied slightly from region to region. Answer: foot. People measured a dash of cloth by the distance between the end of the outstretched arm and their chin. The Romans measured with their pace or steps. Answer: yard. In ancient India, small length measurements used were an dash or a dash. Answer: angul, finger, muti, fist. Even today, we can see flower sellers using their dash as a unit of length for garlands in many towns of India. Answer: forearm. Many such body parts continue to be in use as a unit of dash when convenient. Answer: length. Everyone's body parts could be of slightly different sizes. This must have caused confusion in dash. Answer: measurement. In 1970, the French created a standard unit of measurement called the dash. Answer: metric system. For the sake of uniformity, scientists all over the world have accepted a set of dash units of measurement. Answer: standard. The system of units now used is known as the dash system of units. Answer: international, that is SI unit. The SI unit of length is a dash. Answer: meter. Each meter is divided into 100 equal divisions called dash. Answer: centimeter. Each centimeter has 10 equal divisions called dash. Thus, 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeters. 1 centimeter is equal to 10 millimeters. Answer: millimeter. For measuring long distances, meter is not a convenient unit. We define a larger unit of length. It is called dash. Answer: 1 kilometer. 1 kilometer is equal to 1000 meters. Thank